Implementing Firestore listeners in a SwiftUI project is challenging because SwiftUI state-driven UI doesn't always play well with Firestore's asynchronous real-time updates. Managing data flows, avoiding redundant re-renders, and handling memory leaks can quickly become a headache. But don't worry, this video will break it all down for you in just a few easy steps, showing you exactly how to set up Firestore listeners properly so your app updates seamlessly and efficiently. Make sure to check out the super sale. There are a few days left where you can join SwiftUI Camp and get all of my SwiftUI products. Now, today I'm going to continue on the series of Firestore tutorials. We have taken a look at CRUD operations models, and today we are going to talk about listeners. So what are basically listeners? Listeners are some sort of a pipeline to a certain collection with a query, and we are listening to changes on that query, basically. So if a document has been added, we are going to be notified. And of course, our app will be updated. We are, again, using Firestore Collection. So go ahead and check out the previous episodes of how to install that. Basically, what you want to do is just add Firestore Collection. It's at github.com, Rebeloper, Firestore Collection. And this is my what I have created, my go-to Firestore management library. And I have here under the tabs, you added a cards listener view, basically a new tab. And this is our cards listener view. We are going to build this out today. So let me just build and run so you can see what's going on currently. And we are going to listen to the changes on the cards view. So currently, if I just tap right over here, we are going to fetch all the cards. Cards in a paginated way. Again, go ahead and check out the playlist in the description to know how to do that. Here we are fetching all of the cards at once. We are also counting. And here we are going to have some live updates on the cards. So let's just do this. We need to, first of all, import Firestore collection and GitHub repository that you added. And then we need to create a cards collection. So that is a state variable at state Firestore collection. And we are going to use the path .firestore.cards. Again, take a look at the previous episodes of what this path is and how I'm setting it up. And also, we need to specify the type right over here. This will be a cards collection. Okay, so we have basically access to this cards collection. Of course, we may fetch however we'd like. We are going to take care of that in just a second. Now, here we have our group. We are going to wait for the collection to have some elements. If there are no elements, then we are going to present a progress view. Otherwise, we are going to present the list. It's the same thing what we did in the previous episode. SwiftUI developers, this is for you. I'm running a super sale, bundling all my products at an insane 91% discount. This includes SwiftUI Camp, a 4-week live bootcamp on Zoom designed to take you from SwiftUI enthusiast to expert. The total value is $2,280, but for a limited time, it's just $199. SwiftUI Camp starts March the 3rd, right after the end of this sale. Don't miss this chance to level up your skills. Get the deal right now. The link is in the description. So we need to have an if-else statement. So if cards collection dot. And remember, we are having either a query document if you are fetching only one document from the collection, or we have an array of documents named query documents. So we want to check on the query documents. If this is empty, then we are going to have a progress view. Else, we are going to, well, have a list, of course. List. Inside the list, I'm going to have a for each. And we are going to go through all of the query documents from the cards collection. And we are going to have here a card in. And I'm going to use the cell for the card. The cell for the card is right over here. It's a separate view that I have previously created. It has a delete card, an update card. Again, please take a look at the full tutorial where I set all of this up. Okay, so now that we have this set up, we either going to present a progress view or the list with those documents. We need to start listening, and of course we need to stop listening, because if you don't stop listening, your app will just continuously download or update according to that listener. So we are going to start listening on the appearance of this view, and we are going to stop when this view appears. Pretty straightforward. Okay, let's just scroll down to these two. Oh, by the way, now that we did add the cards collection, I can just comment these out. These were added in the previous episode, so creating a card, updating a card, and deleting a card. As you can see, CRUD operations are really, really straightforward with the cards collection in this way. So we need to add in the start listener and the stop listener. And the API is basically quite the same. So what you want to do is just grab the cards collection and then add dot and then start listening. Now, if you just add start listening with the default values, then what we are going to have is just we are listening to the whole collection. Most probably that is not what you want to do. You want to grab the one with the predicates, animation, and completion. And I don't care about the completion at this point. Whenever a new document enters, that's when the completion is going to be hit. I want to have the one with the predicates, because the animation is set to the default animation, and that's fine with me. So start listening with some predicates. And this is an array of acquired predicates. And I'm just going to listen to the ordered by created at. So we are going to order all of our documents according to the created at. Again, this is listening to the whole collection, but you may add as many predicates right over here as you want. So ordered by. And we are going to choose this one. And the field is, I'm going to copy this out so I don't have any typos. So it is created at. This is a variable, a property on the card model. And then it should be descending. So let's just have this set to true. Okay. The same goes for the stopping of listeners. So we are going to have cards collection dot stop listening. We are just stopping right over here. No predicates, no animation. It's just cutting the listening part. So we no longer are going to receive any updates. Okay. And basically that's it. That's how simple you can set this up. You need to create a cards collection, which you are going to do anyway, because you are using the Firestore collection library. You are going to present all of your query documents, and then you are going to start or stop listening whenever this view appears or disappears like this. So let's build and run one more time. Here we go. Let's go to the live cards. As you can see, it just populated, in this case, everything. Let's just scroll all the way down. And let's just add a new document, for example. So here we go. It's just adding it because it's listening to the changes. Now, what I'm going to do is go to all of the cards. You can see it's right over there because it's fetched it. I'm going to remove the second one with the 536. Let's remove it. And now let's go back to the live card. As you can see, it is removing it indeed. And now I'm going to edit the second card. So right over there, it's now 1134. And here, it's just being updated. And this is how easy it is to just add listeners to your documents, the collections. If you like these types of tutorials, I'm pretty sure that you are going to love SwiftUI Camp, which is part of my super sale. There are a few days left. Go ahead and check it out. The link is down in the description.